have to reach the Empress before Corypheus. The only question is, how?
We know how. I have our way in. The real question is, where is our enemy hiding? At the urging of Grand Duchess Florian, the Empress is holding a ball. Absolutely everyone will be there. During the festivities, Celene will be meeting for peace talks with the usurper Duke Gaspard and Ambassador Briala.
The assassin must be hiding within one of these factions.
Do we need to go to the peace talks? The Empress must have personal guards. We could just warn her she's in danger.
We've made the attempt, but...
It seems that our messages never reached her. Someone intercepted them.
It's better that we don't leave this to chance. If Orlais falls to Corypheus, no land is safe.
Tell me everything we know about the Empress.
Empress Celene is a renowned diplomat and reformer. She works tirelessly to secure peace for the Empire. Unfortunately, many Orlesians view peace as complacency. She has yet to name an heir, leaving the future of the Empire in doubt if anything happens to her. Especially when the next in line is her cousin Gaspard, who's made few friends on the Council of Heralds.
Celene is surrounded at all times by countless guards, courtiers, servants, and vassals. What better place for an assassin to hide than the Empress's own household?
How can Gaspard still be next in line while he wages war against his Empress?
The title Grand Duke indicates that he was a prince before the Empress took the throne.
What do we know about Duke Gaspard?
The man who would have been Emperor. He's Celene's cousin, and was first in line to inherit the throne when Emperor Florian died. Celene outmaneuvered him. She won over the Council of Heralds, who hold authority over title disputes. She became Empress, and he a general in the Imperial Army. He's well-loved by the troops. He's also a Chevalier. Most of their number sided with him when he turned on the Empress.
Aren't the Chevaliers part of the army? Why would they follow the Duke?
Most Chevaliers are sworn to serve the crown, but that does not give them faith in the person wearing it. The Empress has tried to improve relations with Ferelden and Navarra. The Chevaliers see her as anti-military. They believe Gaspard could lead the Empire back to the glory of Draken's expansion years.
Who is this Ambassador Briala?
An ambassador in name only. She has organized the elves of Halam Sharal into an underground army. The Empress invited her to the peace talks in a bid to gain the elves' alliance in the war. That would be scandal enough, without the rumor that Briala is a jilted lover of Celene's. A personal grudge and a network of saboteurs at her command. Promising lead.
Wait. The elven leader is a jilted lover of the Empress?
It's not widely known. Just a rumor whispered among the palace servants a few years ago. If it's true and where to get out. The Empress and an elf. The scandal could destroy Celene's court. Even if a lie, Briala could use it to blackmail the Empress. She has some connection to the throne.
You've given me plenty to think about.
With Gaspard and Celene's armies entrenched, we cannot openly march troops to the palace.
My agents will ensure your soldiers get inside. But it must be a few at a time to avoid attention.
Understood. Just give the word, and we'll begin.
The political situation in Halam Sharal hangs by a thread. The Empress fears our presence could sever it. The Grand Duke is only too happy to have us at the ball as his guests, so our invitation comes from him. Whether we act as his allies, or upset the balance of power, he gains an opportunity, if not a clear advantage.
Inquisitor Trevelyan, it is an honor to meet you at last. The rumors coming out of the Western Approach say you battled an army of demons. Imagine what the Inquisition could accomplish with the full support of the rightful Emperor of Orlais.
And which one was the rightful one again? I keep getting them confused.
If we keep watch, he may appear. Probably by the brandy. I am not a man who forgets his friends, Inquisitor. You help me, I'll help you. prepared to shock the assembly by appearing as the guest of a hateful usurper, my lord. They will be telling stories of this into the next age.
Can't imagine that crowd has seen anything better than us in their entire lives.
I knew we would get along famously, Inquisitor. As a friend, perhaps there is a matter you could undertake this evening. This elven woman, Briala, I suspect that she intends to disrupt the negotiations. My people have found these ambassadors all over the fortifications. Sabotage seems the least of their crimes.
That sounds like something I should look into.
Be as discreet as possible. I detest the game, but if we do not play it well, our enemies will make us look like villains. We're keeping the court waiting, Inquisitor. Shall we?
Is that the Inquisitor?
The mage? No, there must be some mistake.
From the Circle of Ostwick, so they say.
Pardon me, my lord. You haven't seen a ring lying around, have you? It was a gift from the Comtesse Montbelliard, enchanted by the Fomari. I cannot go into the ball without it.
Is this ring particularly valuable?
Its worth in coin is not as important as its social value. It was a gift from a member of the Council of Heralds. If she finds out I lost it, she will never forgive me. Not even if I live to be 1,000 years old.
What's your game? Are you trying to convince the Comtesse that you treasure her gift? Or just gain importance by getting the Inquisitor to run a menial errand for you?
I assure you, the ring truly is lost. And I must find it or risk terrible repercussions. Should you happen upon it, I beg you, let me know. Maker, what am I going to do if I cannot find my ring?
Is this the ring you were looking for?
You are a treasure! I cannot believe you found it! You have saved me a lifetime of mortification. How can I thank you enough?
Foreigners. Any word from the front lines?
My spies said the bodies were beyond counting.
Surely the Empress will put an end to the war tonight.
Pray, my friend. If the Maker does not hear us now, just pray.
Celene prevails tonight.
nonsense here?
Maker, I hope not.
Inquisitor, a moment, if you please. I must warn you before you go inside. How you speak to the court is a matter of life and death. It is no simple matter of etiquette and protocol. Every word, every gesture is measured and evaluated for weakness.
I'll keep my guard up. Don't worry.
The game is like wicked grace played to the death. You must never reveal your cards. When you meet the Empress, the eyes of the entire court will be upon you. You are safer in the Fade with the Fear Demon.
It might be a good idea for the others to hear this warning. Especially Sarah. Maybe tell her twice.
I'll have a few discreet words. Everything will be fine. And rest a watch over us all.
If nothing else, the Inquisition backing Gaspar would make Celene nervous. You know how pious she is.
And now presenting Grand Duke Gaspard de Chalon, and accompanying him, Lord Inquisitor Trevelyan of the Ostwick Circle of Magi. Shepherd and Leash of the Wayward Order of Templars, purger of the heretics from the ranks of the faithful.
Of it. That's not how it went.
Champion of the Blessed Andraste herself.
Did you see their faces? Priceless.
Accompanying the Inquisitor, Seeker, Cassandra, Allegra, Portia, Calogera, Philomena.
Get on with it.
Pentagost, 14th cousin to the King of Navarra, 9 times removed, hero of Orlais. Right hand of the divine. Madame Vivienne, first enchanter of the Circle of Magi, enchanter of the Imperial Court, mistress of the Duke of Ghislaine. Her ladyship, my bulls each, of course. Sir Callum Stanton Rutherford of Honley, commander of the forces of the Inquisition, former Knight Commander of Kirkwall. Lady Liliana, Nightingale of the Imperial Court, veteran of the Fifth Blight, Seneschal of the Inquisition, and Left Hand of the Divine. And Lady Josephine Charette Montillier of Antiva City, Ambassador of the Inquisition.
Cousin, my dear sister.
Grand Duke. We are always honored when your presence graces our court.
Don't waste my time with pleasantries, Celene. We have business to conclude.
We will meet for the negotiations after we have seen to our other guests.
Inquisitor?
Lord Inquisitor, we welcome you to the Winter Palace. Allow us to present our cousin, the Grand Duchess of Leeds, without whom this gathering would never have been possible.
What an unexpected pleasure. I was not aware the Inquisition would be part of our festivities. We will certainly speak later, Inquisitor.
Your arrival at court is like a cool wind on a summer's day.
I'm delighted to be here, Your Majesty.
We have heard much of your exploits, Inquisitor. They have made grand tales for long evenings. How do you find Halam Shiral?
I have no words to suffice. Halam Shiral has many beauties, and I couldn't do them justice.
Your modesty does you credit, and speaks well for the Inquisition. Feel free to enjoy the pleasures of the ballroom, Inquisitor. We look forward to watching you dance.
Inquisitor, a word when you have a moment.
Tell me, Yvette, how are Mama and Papa? Are they in good health? Do they want for anything? Papa's perfectly happy in the studio. Mother is the same as always.
Meaning she's after you to do more work.
You always take her side.
I don't take her side. I happen to think, as she does, you might attend to more of the estate's duties. Also, do stop slouching.
Josephine! Oh, Josephine! Is this him?
Inquisitor, please allow me to present to you my younger sister, Yvette Gabriella Montillier.
There can never be too many Lady Montilliers in Thetis, can there?
Inquisitor, I've heard so much about you, but not as much as I want. Josephine writes, but she never tells me anything. Is it true you found the Red Templars sacrificing heretics and drinking blood from mages' veins?
Yvette!
Everyone in Antifa City is saying so. Is it true?
Oh, it was awful. Mage bones everywhere, practically a carpet of skulls over a river of blood.
Ew! How awful!
Tell me about yourself, Lady Yvette. This is the first time I've encountered any of Josephine's family.
She would forget to mention the artists. I've been studying painting under Antiva's royal tutors. You should be proud, Josie. I'm going to be exhibiting my work next season in the city's biggest salon.
Have you actually sat down and finished the painting yet?
I must wait for my inspiration.
And I must wait for your tutor's bid.
This may be my only chance to hear about when Josephine was a girl.
Oh, yes. As she told you about when she was 10 and...
Yvette. Stop.
Fine. What about when we were climbing the cliffs by the...
No.
She once told the Duke of...
Absolutely not.
Hmm. She still plays with her doll collection when no one's looking.
Yvette! That's absurd. Absolutely preposterous.
Enjoying the ball?
I see many of...
The dancing is so dull, Your Worship. But the Empress's gallery is magnificent.
Yvette.
Sorry, Josie.
Go on, Josephine.
Half our royal must be empty. So many of the Empire's finest are in attendance. They've noticed the Empress paying you special attention, but they don't quite know how to take advantage of it yet. This uncertainty won't last long.
Which power should the Inquisition throw its weight behind?
Celene has held the throne successfully for years. I see no profit in ousting her. Gaspard has run military campaigns, but never a kingdom. His transition would be, let us say, chaotic.
I'll see you later.
Another time!
It's true! The Templars have returned!
How could the Empress afford to wait? Without war going on.
I heard that it wasn't renovations at all. The palace was damaged by Gaspar's catapults.
He fired on the Winter Palace? That's monstrous.
Crotchrot beats his squire. He's a she.
As a bastard. Extra toes. What a fun close marrying crowd.
Making any new friends?
Not likely. I'm watching them watch you. They're all glances and titters. Not sure if they're allowed to like you yet. Pathetic.
Any hidden treasures from friends of your little network?
You mean, do any of the servants ferrying tarts between these windy tits hate them enough to give up a stash or two? I'm not saying yes, but... Wait, yes I am. There's some good stuff hidden around. Keep an eye out.
Any thoughts on who we're investigating?
The Empress is pretty. It'd be fun to drink and kill stuff with Gaspard. Briala is friggin' funny. Elves, elves, elves. But it's really a pissing match with an old lover. Don't know the rest, but that explains a lot. They're all lying, but Celine's nice to look at. Good thing we're here to save her neck.
Back soon.
Not going anywhere.
Good. I was hoping I would catch you. What did the Duke say?
He points the finger at Ambassador Briala.
The ambassador is up to something, but she can't be our focus. The best place to strike at Celene is from her side. Empress Celene is fascinated by mysticism. Foreseeing the future, speaking with the dead, that sort of rubbish. She has an occult advisor, an apostate who charmed the Empress and key members of the court as if by magic. I've had dealings with her in the past. She is ruthless and capable of anything.
How can Celene openly keep an apostate in the Imperial Court?
The Imperial Court has always had an official position for a mage. Before now, it was little better than court jester. Vivian was the first to turn that appointment into a source of real political power. When the circles rebelled, technically every mage became an apostate. The word lost much of its strength.
That sounds exactly like the person we're looking for.
She's worth investigating. Can't be sure of anything here. Both leads point toward the guest wing. It's a promising place to start. I'll coordinate with our spies to see if I can find anything better. I will be in the ballroom if you need me.
And here we are. You haven't embarrassed yourself as much as I feared. Well done, my dear.
Anything happening I should know?
Keep an eye out for Celene's pet apostate. I've no doubt she's involved in this.
Any words of wisdom for navigating the ballroom?
Speak to the Council of Heralds. 6 of them are here tonight. The 7th member of the Council is indisposed. His absence will complicate the negotiations. The Council are the highest-ranking players of the game. They see everything. They might know something we can use.
I've always wondered, what's the Orlesian fascination with masks?
We all wear masks, my dear, not just the people in Orlais. Who you are as a son, a lover, a friend, is not the same man who speaks for Andraste and leads the Inquisition. Orlesians codify this truth, make it visible. By giving each of these selves its own separate face, they believe they can be their truest selves, unmasked.
It seems like you enjoy this, Vivian.
This is the game, Inquisitor. Of course I enjoy it. If I didn't, I'd be dead by now.
Tell me, Vivian, where do you want the crown to fall?
What I want is irrelevant, darling. Orlais requires stability, and that is best served by Empress Celene.
Be ready to act when I give the signal.
Always, my dear.
Laurent was the love of my life. You remember my husband? Poor darling. Killed in a war with Feral then.
Are you married?
I'm married to my work.
Still single?
Look at Lady Cambion's slippers. Trimmed with pearls. And emeralds. And those buckles. Toss her into the lake, and she'll sink right to the bottom. What a disaster.
There's a Tevinter assassin on the loose, and you're concerned about buckles on shoes.
Everyone needs a hobby. Besides, you can learn a great deal about a person from their clothing. Golden jewels on a dancing slipper. A slipper is easily lost, and finds itself in the dust and dirt. She is unconcerned with the possibility of losing the shoe or soiling it. A vulgar display of wealth. But Lady Cambion's family has recently lost most of its holdings. They have their title, but little else. So, how did Cambion acquire such a grand shoe, What has she done? Who has she bedded? These are all useful questions, no?
You're different here than in Skyhold. More approachable, perhaps.
This is Halam Shiral, Inquisitor. This is the Imperial Court. This is the beating heart of the Great Game. Of course, everyone is wearing a mask. I learned this very young. I was still a girl when I attended my first ball. All this, the smiles, the small talk, it is a dance. And like any dance, it can be learned. For some of us, it has become so familiar that the steps may be performed in our sleep.
What do you think the Inquisition should support?
What we need most of all is a stable Orle. Either Celene or Gaspard can give us that.
I should go. Be on your guard.
I always am.
I had hoped to tour the Royal Wing Gardens again.
I have heard they are the finest in the Empire. It's such a pity the wing is sealed.
Inquisitor, did you need something? The sooner we track down this infiltrator, the better.
You've attracted a following. Who are all these people?
I don't know, but they won't leave me alone.
I take it you're not enjoying yourself.
At this point, the headache I'm developing is preferable to the company.
Have you noticed anything out of the ordinary?
Not yet. It would be easier if people would stop talking to me. Other people, not you.
Do you have any advice?
Orlesian social events don't fall within my area of expertise. There are a few here we can trust. Be careful.
Who do you think the Inquisition should support?
Gaspard's claim to the throne is fair. Orle needs someone capable of responding to the crisis at hand. A military-minded leader seems the best option.
We'll talk later.
I await your signal.
I heard Celene was having the entire wing redecorated, but the timing is atrocious.
Why would she do such a thing now?
I still remember the day they came to tell me that my second husband, Philippe, was thrown from his horse.
I heard the Inquisition was here.
You're too gullible.
This ball is a waste of time, like all Orlesian foolishness. Let's find the Venatori collaborator and get out of here.
You don't seem to care much for the ball.
Orlesians pretend their petty squabbles are a game. Yes, let us treat murder, corruption, and deceit as delightful amusements. How wonderful. We are here to save Empress Celene, and it galls me. Why does she merit our protection? The Empire would be better off without her. Gaspard is the leader Orle needs in this crisis.
You support the civil war?
Of course not. Chaos is what Corypheus wants, and we must oppose him. Were it up to me, however, I would let Celene fall and Gaspard take the throne. He would see the true threat, not spend his time throwing balls and writing letters.
Have you witnessed anything noteworthy?
Nothing yet. I will let you know.
I don't suppose you'd like to dance, Lady Cassandra.
Now? This is hardly the time. We're here to find a killer, not dance.
Stay alert. We don't know where the enemy is hiding.
I'll be watching for trouble. The sooner we leave this place, the better.
We are not serving drinks. Bother someone else.
Interesting.
The package is in the guest wing. Upper room.
The one of the garden. Statuette.
I should look around. Interesting. Waste of time.
Gaspard is wasting his time. Nothing he does could win over the Council of Heralds now.
He should have considered that before threatening to burn them all in their homes.
Philippe should have returned hours ago, dallying with some serving girl while I deal with Gaspard's vitriol.
Awfully selfish of this Philippe, running off to play and leaving you with all the work.
I've half a mind to inform the Dowager. That would teach him to shirk his duties to roll some elven maid. Tonight of all nights, leaving me to convey Gaspard's death threats to the Council. Wonderful timing, Philippe. Thank you for listening to me rant. You are too kind, Inquisitor.
Be careful with that tree.
I had no idea.
Well, well, the Inquisitor. Here as a guest of my nephew, no less. I'm curious.
I didn't know the Grand Duke was your nephew.
He's my brother's eldest boy. Always a difficult child, Gaspar. Never listened, never did what he was told. He was raised a prince. All his life we told him he would be emperor. It was his destiny, his duty. What else should he do with his life if not fight for his destiny?
Have you noticed anything strange this evening?
My niece Florian hasn't spoken to me all evening. That's not like her.
What can you tell me about the Civil War?
If you are hoping for insight, you've come to the wrong man. It's war. It is brutal and terrible and sometimes necessary. There's nothing more to say.
Another time, my lord. Good to know.
You don't want to be here, stranger.
Went into the servants' wing. Nobody's come out of there all night.
I'll tell Briala we have a situation.
Did you hear what Gaspar said to Duke Germain? His own uncle.
Germain bore his nephew's spite better than the rest of the council. Did you see that panicked attaché roaming about?
Well, what's this?
My lord Inquisitor,
may we have a word? It is very important.
The Empress has sent us with a message for you.
How can I be certain this message is from the Empress?
We three wear the masks of House Valmont.
They signify that we are public faces of the Empress.
They are also extremely fashionable.
I am always honored to hear from Her Majesty.
Oh, she is the honored one, Inquisitor.
Empress Celene is eager to assist the Herald of Andraste in his holy endeavor.
She will pledge her full support to the Inquisition as soon as the usurper Gaspar is defeated.
That's a generous offer.
The Empress believes wholeheartedly that the Inquisition is our best hope for peace in these difficult times.
She looks forward to cementing a formal alliance.
As soon as Gaspar is out of the way.
But we have taken enough of your time.
Please, enjoy the masquerade, Inquisitor.
Just gossip.
What were they doing in the Western Approach? It's a wasteland.
I didn't expect the Inquisitor to be so delightful.
You must be mistaken.
No, I'm quite certain it was blood on the tiles.
If they're playing the game, they're not doing it very well. You don't leave evidence if you play to win.
With Gaspard and that elf woman here, the only one playing to win is Celene.
You only said that because you fancy the Empress's pet apostate. It sickens me to think of the chaos those Maleficarum are causing across the Empire.
Even you cannot deny that the Templars abandon the faithful in their darkest hour. How can you condone that? They are the ones who should be brought to heel, if you ask me.
Did you need something?
If I heard correctly, you'd like to stop the rebel mages. We share a common goal.
We have had enough of the pyres and the raids and the constant threat of violence. My steward will contact your ambassador. I have skilled people who could be put to great use.
Gentlemen. Just gossip.
Is that him?
Is it true? Is it there was any doubt of a fate I entrusted in me?
The bell. I should get back to the ballroom. That would be the second bell. Fashionably late now.
Well, well. What have we here? The leader of the new Inquisition. Fabled herald of the faith. Delivered from the grasp of the Fade by the hand of blessed Andraste herself.
What could bring such an exalted creature here to the Imperial Court, I wonder? Do even you know?
You may never know. Courtly intrigues and all that.
Such intrigues obscure much, but not all. I am Morrigan. Some call me advisor to Empress Celene on matters of the arcane. You have been very busy this evening, hunting in every dark corner of the palace. Perhaps you and I hunt the same prey.
I don't know. Do we?
You are being coy.
I'm being careful.
Not unwise, here of all places. Allow me to speak first, then. Recently I found and killed an unwelcome guest within these very halls. An agent of Tevinter. So I offer you this, Inquisitor. A key found on the Tevinter's body. Where it leads, I cannot say. Yet if Celene is in danger, I cannot leave her side long enough to search. You can.
You left Celene alone? Is that wise?
I must return to her anon, but she is safe enough for the moment. 'Twould be a great fool who strikes at her in public in front of all her court and the Imperial Guard.
What's your interest in protecting Empress Celene? Are you her bodyguard?
Do I seem a bodyguard to you? If anything were to happen to Celene, eyes would turn first to her occult advisor, even if they knew otherwise. There are sharks in the water, and I will not fall prey to them. Not now, not ever.
Why did you kill the agent? You might have had useful information.
I would not have slain the man on sight had he not attacked me first. Why? Undoubtedly, I caught him in an illicit act. I did not know from whence he came until after the battle, and regret only that I could not capture him alive. What intentions the Imperium has here, I suspect you know far better than I.
Briala's people are whispering about disappearances in the servants' quarters. This key may lead there.
The Ambassador does have eyes and ears everywhere, does she not? Proceed with caution, Inquisitor. Enemies abound, and not all of them aligned with Tevinter. What comes next will be most exciting.
Caught in the middle of this crap. What fully qualified arsehole stops to kill a cook?
They always kill the servants first, my dear. Otherwise they could run and warn someone.
Oh sure, reasonable, innit? Friggin' garbage.
Must be the elves Briala's people are looking for.
Whoever did this ought to be down here somewhere.
This was no servant. What was he doing here?
This man was a Council of Heralds emissary. Curious to find him here.
The crest of the Chalon family. Duke Gaspard will answer for this.
Time to have a word with the Duke.
No! No!
Venatori agents!
Venatori leader. The Venatori were watching this approach. They're organized.
Thank you.
An elven locket, stored away in a palace safe. Unwise, Celene.
Fancy meeting you here. Inquisitor Trevelyan. What a surprise. My report said you were terribly boring. We haven't been properly introduced, have we? I'm Ambassador Briala.
Ambassador, is it? Whose ambassador are you, exactly?
If the nobility is going to treat elves as if we are not citizens, we may as well have the trappings of a foreign power. You clean this place out. Will take a month to get all the Tevinter blood off the marble. I came down to save or avenge my missing people. But you've beaten me to it. So, the Council of Heralds' emissary in the courtyard. That's not your work, is it?
If I did kill him, what would you do?
Well, I wouldn't believe you, for one. You may have arrived with the Grand Duke, but you don't seem to be doing his dirty work. I knew he was smuggling his chevaliers, but killing a Council emissary? Bringing Tevinter assassins into the palace? Those are desperate acts. Gaspar must be planning to strike tonight.
Are you sure he's behind this? He was too easygoing for a man plotting treason.
Don't let his charm blind you. He's illusion. That smile is his mask. I misjudged you, Inquisitor. You might just be an ally worth having. What could you do with an army of elven spies at your disposal? You should think about it.
You know how to make a sales pitch, Ambassador. I'll give you that.
I do, don't I? I know which way the wind is blowing. I'd bet coin that you'll be part of the peace talks before the night is over. And if you happen to lean a little bit our way, it could prove advantageous to us both. Just a thought.
More politics and double dealing. Is there anyone here who is not corrupt?
It's the game, my dear. Everyone plays it here.
Thank you, Inquisitor.
There must be something here. Interesting. Second bell. Fashionably late now.
Inquisitor Trevelyan, we met briefly. I am Grand Duchess Floriane de Chalon. Welcome to my party.
Is there something I can do for you, Your Grace?
Indeed you can. I believe tonight you and I are both concerned by the actions of a certain person. Come, dance with me. Spies will not hear us on the dance floor.
Very well. Shall we dance, Your Grace?
I'd be delighted. You are from the Free Marches, are you not? How much do you know about our little war?
I assure you, the effects of this war reach far beyond the borders of the Orlesian Empire.
Perhaps it does. I should not be surprised to find the Empire is the center of everyone's world.
It took great effort to arrange tonight's negotiations. Yet one party would use this occasion for blackest treason. The security of the Empire is at stake. Neither one of us wishes to see it fall.
Do we both want that, Lady Florian?
I hope we are of one mind on this.
In times like these, it's hard to tell friend from foe. Is it not, Your Grace?
I know you arrived here as a guest of my brother, Gaspar, and have been everywhere in the palace. You are a curiosity to many, Inquisitor, and a matter of concern to some.
Am I the curiosity or the concern to you, Your Grace?
A little of both, actually. This evening is of great importance, Inquisitor. I wonder what role you will play in it. Do you even yet know who is friend and who is foe? Who in the court can be trusted?
I trust the Inquisition, Your Grace. Every man for himself in the Imperial Court, after all.
In the Winter Palace, everyone is alone. It cannot have escaped your notice that certain parties are engaged in dangerous machinations tonight.
I thought dangerous machinations were the national sport in Orlais.
You have little time. The attack will come soon. You must stop Gaspar before he strikes. In the Royal Wing Garden, you will find the captain of my brother's mercenaries. He knows all Gaspar's secrets. I'm sure you can persuade him to be forthcoming.
We'll see what the night has in store, won't we?
You'll be the talk of the court for months. We should take you dancing more often.
It's a relief to do something other than fight demons and horrors.
You still face demons and horrors. These ones are simply better dressed.
Were you dancing with Duchess Florian?
More importantly, what happened in the servants' quarters? I heard there was fighting.
I hope you have good news. It appears the peace talks are crumbling.
The Grand Duchess told me there's proof Gaspard is in league with Tevinter.
She offered up her own brother? She's more cutthroat than I realized.
Then, the attack on the Empress will happen tonight.
Warning Celene is pointless. She needs these talks to succeed, and to flee would admit defeat.
Then perhaps we should let her die.
I thought we were here to stop the assassination.
Listen to me carefully, Inquisitor. What Corypheus wants is chaos. Even with Celene alive, that could still happen. To foil his plan, the Empire must remain strong. This evening, someone must emerge victorious.
And it doesn't need to be Celene. She's right.
Do you realize what you're suggesting, Leliana?
Sometimes the best path is not the easiest one.
You're asking me to decide what's best for Orlais.
More than that, whoever controls the Imperial throne will affect all of Thedas.
You cannot stop Corypheus without a decision. You must support someone. Or all is lost.
Then we should support Celene. She is the rightful ruler. Why would we say otherwise?
Because she led Orlais to this point. I say Gaspard, provided his sister is wrong about him.
I would suggest Briala. She could bring true peace, not only to the Empire, but also to its elves.
This is, however, your decision, Inquisitor, not ours.
We came here to save Celene.
Then you must not only save her life, but also her empire.
That means giving her a victory over both Gaspard and Briala.
If there truly is proof Gaspard's in league with Corypheus, that would be a start.
What did Duchess Florian tell you?
She said Gaspard's mercenary captain is in the royal wing, that he knows about the assassination.
Which could be a trap.
Or a lead. Either way, you should search the private quarters in that wing for clues.
Then get me access, and in the meantime, get your soldiers into position.
At once. Be careful, Inquisitor.
royal husband, Pierre, lost his life to Rosalia, I swore off marriage forever.
You are an interesting one. You have quite the silver tongue, Inquisitor. I do hope you put it to good use.
Have you noticed anything odd this evening?
Too few Imperial guards stand in attendance, my dear. Shame. They are so pleasantly decorative.
I'd like your opinion of this gathering, m'lady.
It's doomed to fail, of course. Celene knows that. At least it should be amusing. We haven't had such a menagerie at court in living memory.
Would you care to dance, Lady Mantillon?
You, Inquisitor, are a delight. One does not often find foreigners so well-versed in the game. But you have other dances to perform first. Perhaps you will save me a dance for later?
Good evening, m'lady.
Mistress Nightingale, what a pleasure to see you again. You look radiant.
Marquis, it's been far too long. How's your family in Valchevin?
No complaints, my dear, no complaints. You must come to the chateau to see the girls. They will be overjoyed.
Oh, I've missed them very much. Little Sylvie must be 10 now, no?
11, and already up to my elbow. Oh, how they grow.
Perhaps I shall call on you soon.
Excellent. Now I must dance with the Dowager. It was lovely to see you, my dear.
Are all the glances here?
Are you happy to see me at all, Josie?
It may not have been wise to attend this particular engagement, Yvette.
I didn't want to come. Mother made me. At least Haram Sharal has such pretty gardens. They're so darling. I took out my parchment.
Not another book of poetry.
I've an idea, Josephine. You should invite all the family to Skyhold for the summer.
You'd be bored the second you stepped past the gates. Skyhold is a fortified castle, not a holiday resort.
Don't you miss us?
Of course I do, Yvette. There's just so much work undone.
You always put these tasks ahead of us.
Well, I'll see if I can come home for your gallery showing. How does that sound?
Oh, that would be so nice. Do you promise?
Yes, I promise.
Oh, wonderful.
Lady Nightingale makes me nervous.
My friend, come in, have a drink. What can I do for you? You've been busily charming the court, I see.
I have a question about the peace talks. What are you hoping to achieve at the negotiations?
I intend to take back what is rightfully mine. Celene stole the crown through politicking, but I am the rightful emperor of Orlais. The empire has been mired in intrigue for too long. We need a clear course of action.
What action did you have in mind?
The empire is declining. We cannot allow Nevarra and Ferelden to chip away our borders. I will see Orlais return to glory as the strongest nation in Thedas.
You intend to return to expansionism?
I like to solve problems in the simplest manner, my friend.
If something were to happen to the Empress, how would that change your plans?
Celene has not declared an heir. If the Maker called her home, the crown would fall to me. But the Council of Heralds would try to implicate me in any misfortune. If they succeeded, the crown could pass to my sister, or one of our more distant cousins.
How have the negotiations been so far?
The port won't last the evening, I'm afraid. We will end the night with nothing settled. Which should surprise nobody, but it will disappoint. I don't know why she had such high hopes for this ball. Florian always was hopelessly optimistic.
The Grand Duchess says you're plotting to kill Celene.
Resorting to rumor-mongering, Inquisitor?
Come, we are beyond such childish stratagems. My sister would never say that. There are no words to convince me that Florian would turn on me.
I'd like to know more about you.
All of Orle knows my story. But you, my friend, are far too sensible to be Orlesian. The heart of it is simple. I am the rightful heir to the throne of Orle. But my cousin, Celene, is a politician, while I am a man of action. She charmed the Council of Heralds. They gave the crown to her, and while it looks fetching on her, I intend to take it back.
What's your claim to the throne?
The Hundred Days' Cough swept Valroya in 877. It killed thousands of children, royalty and commoner alike. There are only three living grandchildren of Emperor Judicale the First. Myself, my sister Florian, and Celene. And I am the eldest. By rights, the crown should have passed to me.
If you're the rightful heir, how did Celene become empress?
I am the oldest, but I lack the Valmont name. My mother was the late emperor's sister. Celene is a Valmont. Her honored father was my mother's brother. But she is the youngest. When there is any doubt surrounding the line of succession, the matter falls to the Council of Heralds. Celene outplayed me, forming alliances on the Council for support. So they passed over me in her favor.
Just what are you claiming? Her crown? Or her head?
If Celene loses her head, it will not be my doing. I want my empire. I do not wish harm on my cousin, but I would not weep at her demise.
We'll speak later, Duke Gaspard.
Another time, friend.
Inquisitor, to what do we owe this honor?
We are always delighted to speak with you, of course.
Her Imperial Majesty is unfortunately occupied at present.
Perhaps you could tell me something, though. We haven't been properly introduced.
How rude of us to forget.
My Lord Inquisitor, allow me to present Lady Couteau.
And Lady Colombe.
And of course, Lady Fleur. We are the Empress's ladies-in-waiting.
I'd like to know more about Empress Celene.
Her Majesty has held the throne since she was just 16 years old.
She is respected and beloved, not just in Orle, but across Thedas.
She doesn't care much for liver, and she drinks her tea black.
I'd like to know more about the negotiations. What is the Empress trying to accomplish with the negotiations?
Peace is her only objective, Inquisitor.
Gaspard and Briala are driven by personal ambitions. But those desires threaten the safety of all Orlesians.
The war must end tonight. We must conclude this to deal with the larger crisis.
What's happening with the peace talks now?
Things do not look promising.
The Grand Duke is as stubborn as always. He will not accept anything but victory in battle.
But the night is young, and Her Majesty will do everything she can to persuade him.
If the evening ends favorably for the Empress, how does the Inquisition benefit?
Her Imperial Majesty brings the might of the Orlesian Empire with her friendship.
She is also a respected diplomat and world leader. She can forge alliances for you with Rivain, Antiva, the Anderfels.
And she throws the best parties.
I made a fascinating discovery. An elven locket in the Empress's vault.
Oh, dear. That is very interesting.
I'll get Her Majesty.
Inquisitor, I regret that we did not have time to speak earlier. No doubt you have questions about many things.
The locket I found. It was a gift from Briala, wasn't it?
She gave it to me for my coronation. I don't know why I kept it. It was a foolish thing to do.
What made the two of you part ways?
She wanted change. And she thought I should deliver it. My word is law, Inquisitor.
But laws don't command people's hearts. Culture does not transform itself overnight. I failed her. I should have dared more. But the past, like so many things, is beyond my command.
Maybe you kept it because you still care for Briala.
Perhaps I do. But I cannot put her above all the people of my empire. Dispose of the locket however you like. It means nothing to me.
Inquisitor Trevelyan. Slumming even more than usual, I see. You've charmed some of the nobles. We'll see how long you can keep their favor. What brings you to me?
I want to know more about the peace talks. What are you hoping to gain from tonight's negotiations?
A voice. Simple enough, isn't it? My people have none. We've lived for centuries amid the lowest ranks of society. No one hears us. No one sees us. If the elves of Halam Shiral were elevated, if we had an elven noble at court, we'd have recognition. A voice.
How will you persuade the Empress to elevate an elf to nobility?
It is already in place. Celene knows she needs us to tip the balance of the civil war in her favor. All we have to do is wait. She'll exhaust her other options and come to us for help. Then, we'll name our price.
How much can a single member of the court do?
It won't remake the world overnight, if that's what you're asking. Our problem is invisibility. The people in power are used to ignoring us. We're not actors. Scenery. We need elves in positions where they can't be overlooked. We need to force humans to take us seriously.
Everyone should have representation in their government.
A start. That's all this is. Something humans can't ignore, and something elves can aspire to. But that's the future. We need to focus on the task at hand.
If Celene were killed, what would happen to your plans?
Assuming I'm not the one blamed? It would be precarious. I've been working on Gaspard, but he's like a charging bull. It would be easier to rein him in if I had something that could hurt him.
I had a question about you, Briala.
I'm an elf, Inquisitor. That should tell you everything you need to know about my life. I'm good at what I do. That's all that matters. I will help my people no matter the cost.
What's your story? How is an elf invited to the Empress's ball as an ambassador?
Empress Celene and I have history. There was a time when I put my spies at her disposal. She knows my qualifications. We had a falling out. Now we are negotiating to determine whether I return to her side in the war.
What do you mean, we had a falling out?
She betrayed me. Turned me over to the guards on a trumped-up charge to save her political reputation. It wasn't personal. It's the game. That's how all Orlesians justify these things to themselves. It wouldn't do to let the court know she had an elven friend.
If she doesn't win you back to her side, what do you intend to do?
I have contingency plans. I'm not a child putting all my hopes on a single ball. This evening gives me access to Duke Gaspard. He's challenging. Not as progressive or persuadable as his cousin. But with time and sufficient blackmail, he might work with us.
I'm surprised you'd admit that, considering the circumstances.
I know it's incriminating. Few harbor more resentment against Celene than I. But if she died after inviting me here, the court would certainly pin her death on me. An elf assassinating the Empress? Alienages across Orlais. Across all Thedas would be purged. That cannot happen.
I've been told you were romantically involved with the Empress.
I didn't take you for a gossip monger, Inquisitor. I suppose your spies have already briefed you, so there's no point in pretending. Yes, Celene and I were lovers once, but we've gone our separate ways now.
I found an elven locket hidden among Celene's things. This isn't yours, is it?
Let me see that. She kept this. What was she thinking? If Gaspard had found this, it would have ruined her.
So this did belong to you?
It was my mother's. Carved from Vinadal wood. I gave it to Celene in
happier times, she held on to it.
We'll speak more later, Ambassador.
Another time, Inquisitor.
Lady Nightingale.
I would love to hear about your time in Kirkwall. Another time.
Maximilian swept me off my feet. It was such a scandal. A fourth marriage to a man almost half my age.
Duke Gaspar wants another bottle of brandy. We'd better have two or three at the moment.
Good to know. Interesting. I had no idea. That's useful.
Gaspar is wasting his time. Nothing he does could win over the Council of Heralds now.
He should have considered that before threatening to burn them all in their homes.
We need more service in the bathroom. Where is everybody?
His own uncle.
Where is that lazy elf?
Spied better
I sent
than the
him
rest
down
of the
to
council.
Interesting. Well, that's useful.
In the ballroom. Where is everybody?
Is it true what they say? You're the Inquisitor, are you not? We heard stories of your accomplishments.
I'd wager I have better tales than anything you've heard.
I told you, Philippe.
Not everyone fights an archdemon and lives to tell. It's an inspiration.
I'm curious, what did you hear about the fight with the archdemon?
They say the army of the Inquisition fought a desperate stand at Haven against the forces of an old god. as the battle raged, you faced down evil incarnate. Spell against fell, its forces had you trapped.
And you cast down a mountain upon the Archdemon and escaped.
Even if a tenth of that is true, it's a remarkable feat.
If you like, Commander Cullen could give you all the details of that battle. He's in the ballroom.
Really? But I shouldn't leave my post.
You'd only be gone a moment.
Philippe, the world is coming to an end. If we don't hear this story now, we'll never have a chance.
You're right. Thank you, Inquisitor. Let's go.
Room after room, and for what? Ruffle storage. Real useful.
I think I'm hurt. No one's supposed to be here. Briala said... Oh, I shouldn't have trusted her.
This wing is sealed. How did you get in here?
Easy. The door was unlocked. One of the others probably handled it.
Briala told you to come to this wing of the palace?
Not personally. The ambassador can't be seen talking to the servants. We get coded messages at certain locations, but the order came from her. She's been watching the Grand Duke all night. No surprise she wanted someone to search his sister's room.
So this room belongs to Grand Duchess Florian?
It used to. This had been her private room in Halam Shiral since she was a child. But this part of the palace was damaged, and the royal family moved to the guest wing.
What were you trying to find in Florian's old room?
The message didn't say. I should have known it was a setup.
Is there anyone else who knows the code and the drop location who could have written those orders?
I don't know. Any of us could do it, but... No. No one else would send me here. It had to be Briala.
It takes great courage to come to the royal wing unarmed.
It's not courage to blindly follow Briala's orders into a trap. I knew her. Before. When she was Celine's pet. Now she wants to play revolution, but I remember. She was sleeping with the Empress who purged our alienage.
Would you be willing to testify to that, if I asked?
Absolutely. If the Inquisition will protect me, I'll tell you everything I know about our ambassador.
Knew it. I did. And I bet the hate made it feel real good.
Go to the ballroom. Find Commander Cullen. He'll keep you safe.
Thank you. Make her protect you, Inquisitor.
Hmm.
What's this then? Swapping all the gold leaf with diamonds, I bet.
You painted Elysian assholes! When I get out of this, I'll butcher you like the pigs you are!
Hello? Is anyone there? Somebody? Anybody?
What happened?
It's not what it looks like. Honestly, I would have preferred it if it were what it looks like. The Empress led me to believe I would be rewarded for betraying the Grand Duke. This was not what I hoped for.
You're telling me that Empress Celene left you naked and trussed like a roast duck?
Please, I beg you, don't tell Gaspard. The Empress beguiled me into giving her information about plans for troop movements in the palace tonight. She knows everything. Everything. The Duke's surprise attack has been countered before it ever began. She's turned it into a trap. The moment he strikes, she'll have him arrested for treason.
She'll be all prim, but here's you with your bits out.
Clever Celene. Even I'm impressed.
I don't know which is worse. Celene for using such a tactic, or him for falling for it.
I'll protect you from Gaspard if you're willing to testify about Celene's trap.
I'll do anything. Anything.
Do they even like being so... like they are?
My dear Maximilian, it took four chevaliers to hunt down the bear that killed him.
Commander, has anyone ever told you that you have the most remarkable eyes?
Several times this evening, actually.
Yeah. So many crimes of fashion.
I found this out. I'm not sure of its value.
Very interesting. It may not help our investigation, but we can put it to use.
I should go. Be on your guard.
I always am.
Oh, sweet Gerard. My fifth husband fell to his death from the bell tower of the Grand Cathedral. To this day, no one knows why he was up there.
Inquisitor, what a pleasure. I wasn't certain you'd attend. You're such a challenge to read. I had no idea if you'd taken my bait.
I had a feeling you were mixed up in all this.
such a pity. You could almost be our Legion, if you were just a little quicker. It was kind of you to walk into my trap so willingly. I was so tired of your meddling. Corypheus insisted that the Empress die tonight, and I would hate to disappoint him.
Your Orlesian royalty. Why would you help Corypheus attack your empire?
You think so small, Inquisitor. Why settle for an empire when Corypheus will remake the entire world? I admit, I will relish the look on Gaspar's face when he realizes I've outplayed him. He always was a sore loser.
Why kill the Empress? What does Corypheus want to achieve?
Celene's death is a stepping stone on the path to a better world. Corypheus will enter the Black City and claim the godhood waiting for him. We will cast down your useless maker and usher in a united world, guided by the hand of an attentive god.
What exactly is in this for you?
The world, of course. I'll deliver the entire south of Thedas, and Corypheus will save me. When he has ascended to godhood, I will rule all Thedas in his name.
You won't get away with this, Florian.
But I already have. In their darkest dreams, no one imagines I would assassinate Celene myself. All I need is to keep you out of the ballroom long enough to strike. A pity you'll miss the rest of the ball, Inquisitor. They'll be talking of it for years. Kill him and bring me his marked hand. It will make a fine gift for the Master.
All that? Were those demons? There aren't any more of those blasted demons coming, right?
Good eye. Those were definitely demons.
Maker bless me. Demons? How could there be demons in the fucking Winter Palace? I knew Gaspard was a bastard, but I didn't think he'd feed me to fucking horrors over a damn bill.
Duke Gaspard lured you out here?
Well, his sister. But it had to come from him, didn't it? And all that garbage she was spewing doesn't mean anything. Gaspard had to be the mastermind.
You honestly believe you were captured, tied up, and thrown into a death trap because of a bill?
When you put it like that, it seems a bit odd. The Duke wanted to move on the palace tonight, but he didn't have enough fancy chevaliers. So he hired me and my men. He had to offer us triple our usual pay to come to Orlais. Stinking, punsy cheesemongers.
Want a new job? One that pays better. The Inquisition can always use a good mercenary company.
You hiring? I'm game. Anything's better than this bullshit. You want me to talk to the Empress, or the court, or sing a blasted song in a chantry? I'll do it.
Thank the Maker you're back. The Empress will begin her speech soon. What should we do?
Wait here, Cullen. I'm going to have a word with the Grand Duchess.
What? There's no time. The Empress will begin her speech any moment.
We owe the court one more show, Your Grace.
Inquisitor.
The eyes of every noble in the Empire are upon us, Your Grace. Remember to smile. This is your party. You wouldn't want them to think you had lost control.
Who would not be delighted to speak with you, Inquisitor?
I seem to recall you saying, all I needed was to keep you out of the ballroom long enough to strike. When your archers failed to kill me in the garden, I feared you wouldn't save me this last dance. It's so easy to lose your good graces. You even framed your brother for the murder of a council emissary. It was an ambitious plan. Celene, Gaspard, the entire Council of Heralds, all your enemies under one roof.
This is very entertaining, but you do not imagine anyone believes your wild stories.
I did not wish to, but it seems I have no choice.
Gaspard, you cannot believe this. You know I would never... Gaspard?
You lost this fight ages ago, Your Grace. You're just the last to find out. Your Imperial Majesty, I think we should speak in private. Elsewhere.
Your sister attempted regicide in front of the entire court, Gaspard.
You're the spymaster. If anyone knew this atrocity was coming, it was you.
You don't deny your involvement.
I do deny it. I knew nothing of Florian's plans. But you... you knew it all and did nothing.
I don't know which is better. That you think I'm all-seeing, or that you're trying so hard to play innocent and failing.
Enough! We will not bicker while Tevinter plots against our nation. For the safety of the Empire, I will have answers.
I wouldn't have caught Florian in time without Briala's help.
You were working together?
Of course.
Thanks to Briala, Gaspard's mercenary captain will testify that he hired men to infiltrate the palace.
Hired thugs? I didn't expect you to stoop so low, cousin.
Don't be naive, Celene. The only difference between a mercenary and a common soldier is a uniform.
Keep talking, Gaspard. Eventually, you'll convince somebody.
There were also the threats Gaspard made to the Council of Heralds to bully them into giving him the crown.
Gaspard is a bully. Is that the worst you can say of me?
And he murdered a council emissary in the servants' quarters. I found his bloody knife hidden near the body. Briala found all of this out for your sake, Celene.
In light of overwhelming evidence, we have no choice but to declare you an enemy of the Empire. You are hereby sentenced to death.
I think Ambassador Briala deserves some reward for uncovering all this.
I can scarcely believe you did all this for me,
Celene.
Thank you, Inquisitor. For all your efforts tonight, I owe you my life, and Orly owes you its future. You have done so much for my people and for us.
We won't forget this.
It was my pleasure. The two of you deserve to be happy.
We truly are. Come, stand with us, Inquisitor. We must give the good news to the nobility. Lords and ladies of the court, this is a night for celebration. Those who sought to poison our empire with treason have been brought to justice. It is a new age for Orlais, We shall build a world in which all men and women live in harmony. Let the cornerstone of change be laid. I introduce the newest member of our court, Marquise Briala of the Dales.
This is not just a victory in Halam Shiral, or within the Empire, or even for elves alone. This is a triumph for everyone! Over 1,000 years ago in the Valerian fields, elves and humans together defeated the Imperium. We can do so much more now. We are greater than our ancestors ever dreamed. Together, we will start by saving our world from the enemy who took the Divine and tore the sky apart.
It will take all of us to defeat the enemy threatening our world.
We are already tracking these Tevinter agents. Soon they'll have no place to hide.
But that is tomorrow. Tonight, we celebrate our newfound fellowship. Let the festivities commence!
The Orlesian nobility make drunken toasts to your victory, and yet you are not present to hear them. Do you tire so quickly of their congratulations, Inquisitor? 'Tis most fickle, after all your efforts on their behalf.
I would have stayed, but the punch ran dry. Scandalous.
Indeed. Let us see if you take this piece of news as poorly. By Imperial decree, I have been named liaison to the Inquisition. Celene wishes to offer you any and all aid, including mine. Congratulations.
I had no idea you were interested in joining the Inquisition.
The assignment has been given to me, regardless of my personal interest. Celene knows you face an opponent who wields great magical power, which is far more important than her own curiosity. You will require my knowledge if you are to defeat such magic. Regardless, Corypheus is a threat to Orlais and to myself. Thus, I am not opposed to the appointment.
What skills do you have that would benefit us?
I have knowledge which falls beyond the realm of most mages. I suspect this is also true of Corypheus. Thus, it behooves you to add to your arcane arsenal, yes? Mundane knowledge will not bring the rift in the sky to a close, after all.
When you say knowledge beyond the realm of most mages, do you mean blood magic?
I know many obscure, forgotten, and forbidden arts. Some of it you might consider blood magic, yes? Should thought of that frighten you, allow me to offer reassurance. Knowledge alone does no harm. What I possess, I place at your disposal to make use of or ignore as you desire.
Welcome to the Inquisition, Morrigan.
A most gracious response. I shall meet you at Skyhold.
I can't believe you escaped before me. A fat count insisted on talking about soup for 15 minutes. We can return to Skyhold whenever you like. The sooner the better. Is something wrong?
Things went according to plan for once. I couldn't be happier.
It is a bit of a surprise, isn't it? We will need to put the soldiers at Skyhold on alert. Better to be safe.
Wait. There is one thing we must do before we go. May I have this dance, Lady Cassandra?
A dance? After all we've been through tonight?
Can you think of a better way to celebrate?
I suppose this isn't terrible.